Bearded Science Guy here, and today we're going to pay tribute to the Martian by creating an emergency electric generator.
Okay, so here's the rub. I've got one working rover designed to go a max distance of 35 kilometers before the battery has to be recharged at the hab. That's problem A. Problem B is this journey is going to take me roughly 50 days to complete, so I gotta live for 50 days inside a rover with marginal life support the size of a small van. So, in the face of overwhelming odds, I'm left with only one option. I'm gonna have to science the shit out of this.
Whether you're driving an electric rover on Mars or trying to charge your phone after a hurricane, electricity can sometimes make the difference between life and death. So today, I'm going to show you how to convert an old drill into an electric generator. Start with an old cordless drill. This one's 18 volts, but other voltages will work as well. Take a metal rod and bend it into the shape of a handle. Then take one end and insert it into the chuck of the drill. Now attach alligator clips, or a spare piece of wire, to the battery clips of the drill. Make sure to keep in mind the polarity of the drill. Now take the other end of the alligator clips and attach it to your electronic device. For this example, we're going to use an LED flashlight. Again, keep in mind the polarity of the wires, so you attach them to the correct positive and negative terminals. To create the most amount of electricity, make sure the torque setting is at its maximum. Put the drill in reverse and make sure to hold down the trigger when you're cranking the handle. At this point, you're ready to go. Start cranking the handle and you should see the LEDs light up. Now, charging a phone is slightly more complicated. As we're turning the handle, we're getting between 5 and 8 volts. So we'll need to limit the voltage to prevent damaging the phone. To do this, we'll add some components. First, connect a 5-volt Zener diode to the negative terminal of the drill. Now connect a 10-ohm, 2-watt resistor between the positive terminal of the drill and the other end of the Zener diode. These components will limit the voltage and prevent you from damaging your phone. You can still charge your phone without them, but be careful of how quickly you turn the drill, or else you'll risk damage. Now take the charger and cut it in half. Isolate the red and black wires. These are the only ones you'll need. Take your alligator clips and attach them to the charger. Again, be careful of the polarity so the electrical current will be flowing in the right direction. This time when you start cranking the drill, you'll see your phone light up and start charging within seconds. After it worked with the old Motorola, I even connected my Samsung S5 and it worked perfectly. However, it will take a while to charge because we're only producing 200 to 300 milliamps. If you enjoyed this video, hit subscribe for weekly science videos. And also check out The Martian on Blu-ray and DVD.